We make a little bit review what we done in last lesson, now in Turkish, but now we passed in English. Now, isentropic process for ideal gases. We define the equation for ideal gases here, totally from the first equation and from the second equation. Now, we are going to create, or we are going to derive isentropic process of ideal gases. And my question is, what is the isentropic process? Please explain in Turkish, in English, whatever you want. What is this? What is the isentropic process? Sesim geliyor mu? Can you hear me? Isentropic process means the process which do not change. I think do not change the entropy. For example, from one state to the other state, something like this, for TS diagram. Okay. And for the isentropic process, first formulations are like this. And what is the isentropic process? S2 is S1. And for the situation, the first equation is zero. Zero is specific at constant volume ln T2 divided by T1 plus R ln specific volume 2 divided by specific volume 1. For the situation, ln T2 divided by T1 is equal to minus R divided by Cv specific constant volume ln specific volume 2 specific volume 1. For the situation, we make a little bit formulation. After that, ln 2, this is the minus, as you see here. We make plus. If we make plus, we change this one, as you see here. After that, we look to what is the R divided by Cm, gas constant divided by specific heat at constant volume. R is for ideal gas, Cp minus Cv, and K is Cp divided by Cv. Therefore, R divided by Cp is Cp minus Cv divided by Cv. This one, R divided by Cv is K minus 1. And for the situation, we come here for the situation. Ln temperature 2 divided by temperature 1 is equal to K minus 1. Ln specific volume 1 divided by specific volume 2. And we make the logarithmic calculation. After that, ln temperature 2 divided by temperature 1 for S constant is equal to specific volume 1, specific volume 2 to the power of K minus 1. This is our first formulation. This is, again, isentropic process for ideal gases. And the second one is, we created for the second equation, because the first equation is like this, as you remember. First equation is like this, we define like this. After the second equation, we use this one for creating formulation for ideal gases and isentropic process. Okay. From the second equation, again, S2 and S1 is equal. It's zero. Specific heat at constant pressure. Ln T2 divided by TV is equal to, or minus L R ln gas constant ln pressure 2 divided by pressure 1. And for the situation, this is zero. The first term is equal to second term. And ln temperature 2 and temperature 1 is equal to RCP ln P2 divided by P1. What is RCP? RCP minus CV. CP is like this. Therefore, RCP is k minus 1 divided by k. And for the integral calculation, t2 divided by t1 for s constant isentropic process is equal to p2 divided by p1 to the power of q minus 1 divided by k. And from the first equation, this one, and from the second equation, because as you see here, t2 divided by t1, both of them start t2 divided by t1. And therefore, for this term and this term is equal. And for the situation, p2 divided by p1 is equal to specific volume divided by specific volume 2 to the power of k. And we created three formulation from ideal gas and isentropic process. Okay. And for the situation, they explained here, and we said that for ideal gas, T specific volume K minus 1 is constant. Tp 1 minus K divided by K is also constant. And P specific volume to the power of K is also constant. Okay. You look the formulation and you see that this is valid for this, my explanation, my handwriting. Okay. And for the situation, isentropic process for ideal gases, we make exact analysis. Exact analysis, as you know, that S0. S0 comes from the table A7 or table A21, for example. I mean, it takes from ideal gas tables. For the situation, for specific analysis, this is the isentropic process. This is the S20 minus S10, R, ln, P2, and P1. This is from the second formulation, as you know that. And for the exact analysis, for example, S20 can be found for this, for this formulation. Okay, maybe we can set it for this formulation. And we looked the now we looked the NIV definition, relative pressure and relative specific volume. Also for this definitions can be also found in the tables. Okay. And for the situation, firstly, we are going to explain the, also I'm going to explain the relative pressure. From this formulation, also maybe we can say from this formulation, P2 divided by P1 is equal to, from the logarithmic formulation, P2 divided by P1 exponential. Exponential means E to, like this, power S20 minus S10 divided by R. Okay. Like this. This is E. Okay. This is the exponential. E is a constant, as you know that. So as you know that, ln E, what is ln E? Do you know that?
One.
Okay. Therefore, we can, you're right. Therefore, we try to find the P2 divided by P1. Therefore, we use ln E. Okay. And this is the exponential S2 zero minus S10 divided by R. For the situation, okay, new definition, exponential S0 divided by R is relative pressure, new definition. And we make the P2 divided by P1, exponential S20 divided by R is equal to exponential S4 divided by 1. Therefore, this is P relative 2 divided by P relative 1. Okay. For the situation, we look to tables, maybe. In which formulation, in which tables gives the relative pressure and relative? As far as remember, table A7, 60 maybe, or A17. As you see here, for the table, for air, table A17, it gives relative pressure and relative specific volume. Now we know the what is relative pressure. Now I'm going to explain what is the relative maybe I can firstly come here, I can delete this for clarity. And for the situation, from the ideal gas P1, pressure 1, multiple specific volume divided by T1 is equal to pressure 2, specific volume 2 divided by temperature 2. For the situation, specific volume 2 divided by specific volume is equal to T2 divided by T1 multiple P1 divided by P2. And T2 divided by T1 is constant, but P1 divided by P2 can be writing here from the relative pressure. T2 relative pressure 1 divided by T1 relative pressure 2. And for the situation, T2 relative pressure 2, T2 divided by relative pressure 2, totally divided by the T1 divided by pressure, relative pressure 1 is equal to specific volume. Specific volume 2 divided by specific 1. Therefore, for the situation, T divided by relative pressure is equal to relative specific volume. Therefore, specific volume is S constant is equal to specific relative specific volume 2 divided by relative specific volume 1. It means T2 relative pressure 2, T1 relative pressure 1. Okay. And for this knowledge, we can solve the two problem. Example 7.10 and 7.11. For the situation, air compressed in a car engine from, for the first state, I mean that, 22 centigrade and 95 kilopascal. This is the first state. And this is a reversible and adiabatic manner. It is isentropic. This is the reversible, internally reversible. And there is no heat transfer between the system and its surroundings. It is adiabatic. For this condition can be together, it means isentropic process. That means entropy is constant, or entropy remains constant. If the compression ratio V1, volume 1 divided by volume 2 of the piston cylinder is 8, then determine the final temperature. Okay, this is the closed system, and this is the for initial state, 22 centigrade and 95 kilopascal, and the compression ratio is 8. And what about the temperature 2? And for the situation, this is the closed system. For closed system, specific volume ratio is equal to specific volume ratio. And after that, as you know that, We looked to relative specific volume because relative specific volume is equal to like this, is equal to, maybe for clarity, T divided by specific relative pressure, as you know that. Therefore, first we calculate the specific volume to, and after that we looked in the table and we get the temperature. Firstly, this is air compressed. Okay. This is keep. And we look to this table, ideal gas of table. And for the temperature one, 291, here our specific volume or relative specific volume is 647.1. And what about the relative pressure? 1.3068. Okay. We know the from ideal gas table, table A17. For the situation, we find the from the table A17, we found the relative pressure, pardon, relative specific volume. And for the situation, as you remember that relative specific volume 2 divided by relative specific volume is equal to specific volume to specific volume 1. As you know that from here. From here. Okay. And for the situation, we calculate relative specific volume 2. For the situation, relative specific volume 1, we get from the table. And the compression ratio is 8, first volume divided by second volume. But for this formulation, second volume divided by first volume, this is also specific volume. And specific volume is related to normal volume. And this is the this one. Relative specific volume 2 is 80.99. And from the table, we get 80 specific volume 2. Specific volume 2 is 80 like this, between this one. Am I true? 80.99. And we make interpolation here. I'm going to make a screenshot. 80, this is the temperature. And we look to this one. It means that between 660, the temperature, the new temperature, or second state temperature is between 660 and 670. For the situation, maybe I'm going to make here, maybe a little, I make like this. This one I delete. This one I put here. And make a screenshot or cutting process again. For the situation. Okay, I divide, delete this. This is temperature, this is specific, relative specific volume. And from the linear interpolation, okay, this is the, because our new relative specific volume is like this. Pardon. Like this. Therefore, new temperature is 662.7 Kelvin. Okay. You can do this from linear interpolation. And what about the new problem? This problem is also the simple like previous problem. Helium gas is compressed. Again, it's the compressor. And this is Turkish. Writing in Turkish, this is also Turkish. Helium gas is compressed in an adiabatic compressor from initial states 100 kilopascal and 10 centigrade, and final temperature is 160 temperature. Maybe you think that first again gives the initial state, previous temperature, and it gives the compression ratio, and they ask to us from the problem, what is the temperature? For this situation, it gives the pressure and temperature at the initial states. After that, it gives the temperature, and they said that what is the exit pressure of helium. This is the second state of the pressure. Okay. And for the situation, P2, and as you know that we have formulation, P and temperature relation between them. P2 is equal to P1 T2 divided by T1 to the power of K divided by K minus 1. For the situation, P1 is 100 kilopascal. From the book, they explain with the not Kelvin. This is, I think, wrong, because in all thermodynamic calculations must be done with Kelvin, not Rankine, not Fahrenheit. Okay. Therefore, I delayed it for temperature 2 is 106 centigrade. It means 430. This is 110 centigrade. This is the 10 centigrade. And I converted this temperature to Kelvin scale, because Kelvin scale is the thermodynamic temperature scale. And for the situation, from the helium, helium K is 1.667. From helium, helium K is 1.667. Okay. And for the situation, K is 1.67 and K minus 1 is 0.67. For the situation, R pressure 2 is 289.968 kilopascal. Okay, this is similar maybe, but all the problems can be calculated from the Kelvin, not Rankine or not Fahrenheit or not centigrade. Okay.
Hocam, bir şey sorabilir miyim? K-1'in negatif olması gerekli değil mi? Pardon, tamam. Şu an anladım.
Okay. Okay, maybe we can look. We have 10 minutes. We can look in table, maybe. What is K? Maybe. From the table 2, huh? From the common gases, carbon dioxide, helium here. Maybe here, table A2, helium. This is the CP calculation. Maybe, but we don't know the from the table for what is the K in helium. Because air, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, it comes here. But helium cannot give it from the tables. Also, the problem says us the K is like this. Okay. Now we look the new reversible steady state flow work. Okay. We have machine or heat engine. This is reversible and steady state flow work. The work, and we'll look the formulation here and we create it a little bit and we go in detail. And first I'm going to explain what is the reversible state flow work. The work done during a process depends on the path, flow, as well as on the properties and states. And recall that reversible quasi-equilibrium moving boundary work associated with the closed system is expressed in terms of flow properties. And this is from the equation. This expression is from the equation. First, I'm going to explain what is the reversible. The process is reversible from comp 1 to 2. And this process comes in the same path. This is from 2 to 1. This is reversible, as you know. And if there is closed system, and for the make the reversible, the moving make so slowly quasi equilibrium, therefore we set the reversible. And for the situation, we look to steady state flow work, and we look again, of course, flow properties. For example, from the first formulation TDS du plus PdV, this is the Gibbs equation. From the second formulation, TDS dH minus V dP from the second equation. And we use here second equation. Okay. After that, we use the thermodynamic first law for the closed system. And firstly, we calculate the Q delta Q reversible is equal to TDS, as you know that. And for reversible process, we can calculate as you know that DS delta chronicle delta reverse divided by T, as you know that. Or maybe this is D. Okay. And they said that this is the path process, therefore we can use the chronicle delta. Okay, we can calculate the entropy from the reversible process. Therefore, we can delta Q reversible is equal to TDS. And for the situation, TDS is equal to heat transfer from the reversible, DH minus VDP. And we calculate, we remind this process or this formulation first. What about the second thermodynamic first law? What about the thermodynamic first law of the closed system? As you remember, maybe you don't remember, but I'm going to remind this. Q minus work, heat transfer minus work, dH plus the kinetic energy and kinetic energy changing and potential energy changing. Okay, potential energy changing. For the situation, Q is dH VdP minus this one, dH, the kinetic energy, and the potential energy. dH goes zero here, and this is the minus work, okay, is equal to VdP. And kinetic energy changing and potential energy changing. Okay, this formulation comes here. This formulation comes the closed system and thermodynamic first law. Okay, and this formulation and this formulation is similar. And for the situation, for reversible flow work is equal to VdP. Make integral and delta T kinetic energy and delta T potential energy. And if we neglect the kinetic and potential energy changing, reversible steady state flow work for heat engine or whatever, or one closed system is equal to reversible VdP. Okay, this is so important, but if we don't change, if kinetic energy and potential energy are so important and we cannot neglect this. Therefore, reversible steady state flow of work is again delta kinetic energy and delta potential energy. And for the situation reversible steady state work is minus specific volume P2 minus P1 is minus delta kinetic energy and delta potential energy. Okay. And for the situation, and we looked at this formulation, reversible steady state flow work. And for the steady state flow, okay, so important. This is the boundary work. This is the kinetic energy. And this is the potential energy, as you know that. And this formulation is really non-formulation. Its reputation is so high because we use in thermodynamics, fluid mechanics. Okay, this is Bernoulli equation. Also, this Bernoulli equation is also can be used for all, not all, I mean that, but for most flow. And as Faray is remember, I mentioned one book, the Dünyayı Değiştiren Beş Denklem, Five Equations, which changed the world. From this equation, from the Bernoulli equation. Okay, this is so important. This is Bernoulli equation. Please remind this and please try to understand this formulation. And for this situation, reversible steady state flow system, flow work is equal to if the kinetic energy and potential energy is neglect like this. Okay, VDP, or for closed systems, maybe as you remember that PDV, as you remember, pressure is constant and volume is changing, but for open system, like this. And the last explanation of the for this situation, the largest specific volume creates the greater work produced or consumed by a steady state flows. If the R specific volume is higher, R work is higher. If the specific volume was smaller, work is smaller. Okay. And we have make 10 minutes break. After that,